Hey guys, so I don't know how this video is going to come out because I'm using the cell phone that always gives me a delay. Because if I use my other phone, it's going to stop. Because I know I'm going to be text. So, what I wanted to put on camera, I'll probably speed this up, but I just wanted to show you that I forgot to show this on the video I just uploaded. I was thinking about Diane and Shawcraft One. And she was gluing a bunch of napkins on tags and whatnot. And I was trying to figure out what to do with these envelopes that I have. And so I decided to try gluing the napkin on the envelope, but I'm gonna have to go over it with some decoupage glue because I think this will tear, as you know, being an envelope, but I'm gonna put it in between a signature. I think it will tear, so just to reinforce it, I'm just gonna decoupage over it to make it a little bit sturdier. But I really, really love how it came out. I still want to put the decoupage over it, and then I want to ink around the edges. The windows aren't perfect, but I still like it. I really, really like it. So I thought I would do one on camera just to show you. Here's another one that I did. And so, like I said, I haven't decoupaged or inked it up yet. So I thought I will do that on camera really fast. So I'm going to use this. I think I'm going to use this napkin because I think that would be really pretty across there. So I can cut this one in half. Probably should have already did this, but there we go. Thank you. It came right off. I don't even have to use tape. I might have to for this. For this layer though. Everybody learned this, I think, from Crafty Irina. To get the layer off with tape. And for some reason, this one wants to be stubborn. Come on. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to take my glue stick and I'm just going to glue the bottom half first because I have the fan on, it's going to glue, I mean, it's going to dry really fast. Sorry if I'm shaking the camera. It would reach all the way. Okay. doesn't reach all the way, you guys, but that's okay. But you don't want to glue the windows. But you could do this a lot better to get all your wrinkles out, but I like the wrinkle look, so I don't really worry about the wrinkles too much. Now normally I will wait until this is dry, but I want to cover the top. Will it reach? It's not going to reach all the way. So I want to cut this piece off. Could have slid that a little further up, but I didn't. So I'm just gonna cut. My fan is like blowing it everywhere. It doesn't bother me to have it upside down like this because it's the flap. So for me, it doesn't really make a difference. But for you, you might want to use a bigger napkin. But I don't mind. I personally don't mind. It's a whole lot neater than me, but no. This is how I do stuff. All right, so I'm just going to trim off camera. I can't see So, there we go. How pretty is that? So then what I do is I carefully, actually, where is my, there we go. So this is pretty dull. So I'm not gonna press really hard. You may find something else you can use, something that may be less pointy, so you don't cut through the plastic. But this kind of works for me. It's a little tedious, but it does the job. I mean, you have to be really careful that you don't tear where you don't want to tear. I mean, it doesn't bother me if it gets a little torn where I don't want it to tear, but for the most part, I try to keep it just where the window is. And I alternate, where's my other scissors, between that and scissors, because I think with scissors I have a little bit more control with the pressure, so I don't cut the window. Get out that big piece, then you're able to kind of clean it up, I guess. Yeah, just tore a little bit where I didn't want to, but that's okay. Probably an easier way to do this, but I was just playing around with this yesterday and I haven't figured out. Oh, see, I really tore way more than I wanted to tear on that one. But I think it's an easy fix. We're just going to cheat a little bit. This fan will stop blowing my paper. I'm not turning it off, so I'm just going to. So just cut a little thin. Hopefully it doesn't rip because my hand's a little sticky. Little strip right there. Just so I can cover up my mistake. Okay, I think that's pretty good. So let me just do the other one, if I can see through it. Which is another thing, gotta be able to see through your napkin. So you can see where you're cutting. Alright. Sorry guys, but it's the only way I can see what I'm doing. This is why I don't do process videos, because I just feel like I'm so awkward. pressure is on when you're on camera. See how far over the window goes. Really quiet. So I'm just gonna try to clean it up best I can. I think that is pretty good. I think I got some glue on that part of the window, but I'm not gonna worry about it. So just wanna get some glue under here. Darn it. Set up before I stab myself, because I have done that before. There we go. So that is what we got. So we have 3 envelopes. I think they came out pretty good. And now I'm going to decoupage them. I'll just do one on camera, and I will, this is actually not Mod Podge, this is decoupage glue sealer and some water. Learned that from Crafty Irina too. So put it in the Ziploc so you can save it. We'll use it over and over again. going to pat because I think that I will rip it because I am quite heavy-handed. So I like to do the pat method. I love those wrinkles. I live for the wrinkles. I love the wrinkles. Not so much in my face, but I like them on my paper. This one is good. I'm actually going to take some of my, I've got to make some more, my homemade clear shimmer. Because I like a little shimmer sometimes. And I'm going to move this. It can dry. Okay, so we're back. First part looks good. Didn't look like there was a delay. So I briefly just took some shoe polish from the Dollar Tree. Learned this from Crafty Irene, I believe, too. And I just inked around the edges. And I literally took a Q-tip and went around the window. So it looks really grungy. You may or may not like that look. I kind of like it. So that's one. This one I'm going to use just some Tim Holtz Distress Ink. And that's it. We're just going to call it a day. I'm going to do this one. And that's it. I don't know if I'm going to do any further decorating, but if I do, I will put pictures of it on IG. Well, I'm going to put pictures of them anyway on IG. So you'll see whether I further decorated or not. Because the other one is still a little wet. I just wanted to get these done so that I can finish up these journals. Sorry if I'm off camera. Sorry, you guys, if I'm off. I didn't even realize. Just inking and talking and not paying attention. Like I said, this is why I don't do process videos. Not that I don't want to do them, but I just feel like I suck at it. Because I forget. And I'm supposed to be showing you what I'm doing. So I inked all around it. I really do want to do the windows, but I thought I could cheat and use my distress marker, but it's all dried up. And I rarely even used it, and it's all dried up. Maybe that's why. Let's see if I could dip it in the distress ink. Yeah. Look at that. It's working. Of course, you don't have to do this if you don't want to. Defining the windows. You can, I'm sorry, I'm all quiet when you guys see what I'm saying? I totally forget sometimes I'm on camera. So you can add like lace or stamping or stickles or anything you want really to further decorate if you want to be fancier. I may add some more stuff to it. I don't know. Oh. I don't know. I might. I do want a little shimmer on this one, though. So I'm just going to give it a squirt. I really have to make some more. Because I barely have anything in here to squirt. Baby wipe and just clean up the window so it's not all foggy with my shimmer. I'm gonna take a towel and dry it up a little bit. Alright, guys, I think that's so cute. You can, I think I want to ink that bottom. This is going to be an envelope. Should have did that because it's still wet, but that's okay. So, there we go. The other one, like I said, is still wet. So, there we go. Hope that inspires you. I know it's all over the place. I was inspired by Diane from Shawcraft One. Yes, she decoupaged the tags, which I actually did make some myself with the parchment paper somewhere. I just haven't put the, I sewed it, But it's a little wrinkled, but that's okay because I like my napkins wrinkled. I think it'll be all right. So I did sew on the, what do you call it, parchment paper. So I just have to decoupage it. And so once I'm done with all of that, you guys, I'm going to post pictures on my IG. So if you're not following me on IG, make sure you do so. Thank you, Diane, for the inspiration, and I hope you guys was inspired. If, I mean, I'm sure this is probably nothing new, but I was hit by some inspiration yesterday when I was trying to figure out what to do with these envelopes. So, hope that'll give you an idea on something else to use in your junk journal. So, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you all, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.